It's the resumed hearing in the case of fraud against Mr. Olisametu, a former National Publicity Secretary of the People's Democratic Party. As part of the proceedings, the trial judge delivered his ruling on an application filed by Mr. Metu on the 2nd of June 2018, seeking to reopen his case, which was closed by the court at its last sitting a month ago. In his ruling, Justice Okunabang held that the court cannot assume appellate functions and sit on an appeal in respect of its decisions. But in the instant case, Metu was not in court when the order was given, and it behoves on the court to give him an opportunity to explain himself. The judge added that the explanation would, however, not decide the position of the court. But Justice Abang went ahead to rule that the court will bend backwards in the interest of justice and set aside its earlier ruling, which had closed Metu's case.
We brought an application to for his lordship to revisit that issue to enable the first defendant testify, and graciously, fortunately, the judge granted that application.
On his summons regarding Channels Television, the trial judge, after watching the relevant clips of the Sunrise Daily program broadcast on May 22, 2018, discharged a member of staff of Channels Television, Mrs. Maokwe Ogun Yusuf, as according to him, she had nothing to do with an attempt to prejudice the court, as she had not appeared on the said program. Justice Abang, however, ordered the Attorney General of the Federation to arraign three members of staff of the station and a guest on the program to determine whether they allegedly made statements that were prejudicial to Mr. Metu's trial. The judge, however, left out a representative of the Economic and Financial Crimes Commission who joined the discussion via phone on the grounds that he heard a voice said to belong to the EFCC representative, but he did not have a sight of him in the video clip. Prior to making the order, the trial judge noted that he had no jurisdiction to make findings if the said statements were indeed prejudicial, but that he only had the powers to refer the matter to appropriate forums that have the powers to determine whether the statements were prejudicial or not.
One was said to be a Mr. Johnson, whose voice was only heard. He wasn't there in person. I think they contacted him on phone. So the judge said it would be speculative for him to make an order against somebody whose identity he doesn't know. So I think I give it to him that since that person was not physically he did not participate in the program, it would have been wrong maybe to make an order against him. But since the matter has been referred, that doesn't stop the committee or whoever is going to look into it to go into the root of the matter with respect to getting how or who participated in it.
My Lord has made a direction, and the AG would react.
The trial has been adjourned to the 4th of July for continuation. Amaka Okafor, Channels Television News.